Disney has revealed the first look at Mary Poppins Returns, the sequel to the 1964 musical classic that starred Julie Andrews and Dick Van Dyke. Based on the Mary Poppins story by P.L. Travers, the movie is set in 1930s Depression-era London and finds kids Michael and Jane all grown up. After Michael suffers a personal loss, Mary Poppins, played by Emily Blunt, returns, along with an optimistic street lamp lighter named Jack, played by Hamilton creator/star Lin-Manuel Miranda, to help the family rekindle their sense of magic. It is set for release on Christmas 2018. Christian, buy or sell the first look at Emily Blunt as Mary Poppins.
I'll slightly buy it. I think that I could go to Disneyland and see anybody wearing this. Does she look like Mary Poppins? Yes. I am way more excited about the movie than Mark Ellis is. I think that Emily Blunt is incredibly well cast for this. I think that it's a good time to retell this movie this many years later. But the image itself, okay, great. She looks like Mary Poppins.
You know, there was a time when I, much like Mark Ellis, was grim and dull, saw no light, the sun didn't shine for Mary Poppins. But you know what? Gradually, little bit by little, I've been getting more excited about. I don't know why. I don't know how that transition happened. But maybe it was the more and more that the cast that got added. Maybe it was more and more hearing Emily Blunt actually talking about it, and then seeing this role. It's that tangibilization again of it's kind of real, and you see that they're going, the aesthetic that they're going for, it feels very much like Mary Poppins again. So look, I'm not jumping out of my chair about this. I'm not like looking forward to this as much as I'm looking forward to, say, like a Wonder Woman or the next Star Wars movie, but I am feeling my enthusiasm for this getting a little bigger. So for this image, I'm gonna buy it.
I just want to address Christian Harloff in saying that the Mary Poppins at Disneyland is only wearing the white gown from when they were in the painting. That is brand new. You will never see that there, my friend.
It's a great hat, though.
It is a great hat. But Emily Blunt, as I've always been cautiously optimistic about this new Mary Poppins movie, because Mary Poppins is a classic from my childhood and whatnot, much like Tron.
crossover.
yeah. The Disney crossover is never... But Tron most certainly needs a remake. Mary Poppins I was a little more cautious about, but Emily Blunt is the perfect casting for a modern-day Mary Poppins. And that premise, that picture mixed with the synopsis I just heard right over there about little Michael's grown up, he suffers a loss, so Mary Poppins comes back, because Mary Poppins was always about helping the parents find joy. It wasn't about the kids, you know? Right. When you're a kid, you think it's about the kids. Then you see Saving Mr. Banks, you're like, what did I believe all my life? No. It's all about the parents. And at that point, I'm buying this for sure. I'm looking forward to it. I think she's great. Just everything just came together right here in this moment. Let's go to the banker over here who says, Tuppence humbug. What do you think?
Well, to quote Billy Madison, more like boron, am I right? Look at that bag, Grandma. You going to Laughlin to play the nickel slots? Who cares?
Borophil.
I'm not upset at this picture. I'm not. It's again, I'm not getting out of bed. Ashley, I'm not getting out of bed for your boy Jared Leto. I'm certainly not getting out of bed for a Mary Poppins sequel. The guy's an adult and he suffers a loss, and it's like, go to work. Shut up.
I'm gonna make a prediction. I'm gonna make the same prediction that I for La La Land also, is that you didn't give a crap about La La right. Land. You didn't care about the musicals. I bet you that he's teary-eyed. I bet you he's raving about this movie after he sees it. I know you so well. I guarantee you that you're going to love this movie.
Mary Poppins 2 could be my rock dog, and I'm going to give you the credibility to say
she
that.
Don't have a guitar, man. It ain't happening. She don't know how to rock those strings.
As far as the first image of a movie goes, I actually think this is pretty cool, because you're not revealing anything. You're just teasing us with those notes of nostalgia. So job well done on the picture. I don't care about your movie.
And with that joke, we have now promoted Rock Dog more than the studio has.
You know what's funny is I imagine you like Bill Murray in Groundhog Day, just like neck deep in your bed, not getting out of bed for anything. Like, get on your booties because it's cold out there today. As the camera pans up from you, you are every adult that Mary Poppins ever tried to save, my friend.
I don't remember her saving the adults. I just remember her babysitting some kids, throwing some sugar in their mouths, and then leaving. Right?
Look, but I'm really glad you brought it up, because, like, seriously, I can't say this enough. If you guys have not, and I know a lot of you haven't, if you did not see Saving Mr. Banks
with
Colin Farrell and Tom Hanks, watch Saving Mr. Banks, because it will, number one, get you really revved up to watch a Mary Poppins movie for sure. But just on its own, it's a brilliant film that I actually thought Colin Farrell should have been nominated for the Academy Award for.
I don't know, I'm getting revved up to watch Mary Poppins.
You will get revved up, sir.
Like, I just saw Tom Hanks as Walt Disney. Boom, boom. Put on the pop.
You're going to get out of bed for that one. I promise.
All right, what's next?